Hello friends, welcome to my channel ELS, English Literature Studies with Kaur Harpreet. Today my topic is on Elizabethan Theatre, what Elizabethan Theatre was and how it was framed. So before starting my lecture, we will study about the condition of theatre as we were discussing about Shakespeare's contribution in drama. So let us start with the video. Elizabethan Theatre. Before talking about theatre, I will try to give a short view of Elizabethan drama, because drama is concerned with theatre. So Elizabethan drama was the dominant art form during the reign of Queen Elizabeth I. Before this, morality plays and interludes were staged in open or in churches. At that time, wagons were used to move these amateur actors from one place to another. Or we can say there were no permanent theatres at that time. Elizabethan theatre is also known as English Renaissance theatre because it only refers to the period of reign of Queen Elizabeth, and that time is from 1588 to 1603. English Renaissance theatre encompasses Elizabeth theatre, Jacobean theatre and Carolean theatre, and these three theatres are given with their dates. So let us talk about the first playhouse and first playwrights. The establishment of large and public theatre was in demand for the success of English Renaissance drama, but their construction was prompted as a measure against plague. So at that time, an actor, James Burbage, built the first successful English playhouse in London, and this playhouse was simply called the theatre. It was supported by young playwrights, later known as university wits. Another theatres were built to control the audience, so the theatre was followed by these theatres. And the theatre was supported by young playwriters known as university wits, which are Robert Greene, John Lilly and so on. I have already discussed in my previous video, and you can watch this video. And the Curtain Theatre was established in 1577. Then the Rose Theatre, then Swan Theatre, the Globe Theatre, the Fortune Theatre and the Red Bill Theatre. And these are the dates given in a chronological order. Coming to the characteristics of Elizabethan Theatre, this theatre was the focal point of Elizabethan age. It was the epitome of entertainment for the audience of that time. It includes comedies, histories and tragedies also. And these were indicated through flags. These flags, when the comedies or histories or tragedy, when these dramas are going to be staged, they used to advertise these plays through flag, right? And projected their comedy, history or tragedy with the help of flag, so that they could see, people could see the flag in advance and decide whether they want to see it, see that drama or not. And comedy was indicated with the help of white flag. For history they used red flag, and for tragedy they used black flag. So it was easy for them to decide whether they want to see the drama or not. And then advertisements, there were advertisements for dramas, and dramas were played only during daytime, and there were no curtains, and there were no night shows, because the government didn't want plays to go on in night due to some safety reasons. And or with this we can say there was no physical intimacy, no love scenes were performed. And these scenes were verbal, right? Dramas were played only during daytime. Rich costumes by companies were given, and very few stage properties were used to perform their scenes. Scene changing were verbally as love scenes, and these rich costumes were owned by the companies. Then the stage was also the scene of soliloquy, in which an actor was directly conversing with the audience, as we see in Shakespearean dramas. And then there were no female performance, there were no woman character on stage at that time, and they were not allowed to perform on the stage. It was illegal against law to make female come front of audience. And their characters were played by young adolescents, boys, And those women who attended the plays, plays came masked to not to be recognized. So these are some characteristics of Elizabethan theatre, and I hope you will like my today's video. And if you like it, please hit the like button also, and share it with your friends. If you are new on my channel, please subscribe my channel and hit the bell button also, so that you can get notifications for my upcoming videos. So friends, thanks for today.